Dear student, this is Vaishali Mehta from VPMP Polytechnic, lecturer in Computer Department. Today's my unit is Introduction to HTML and CSS, in which we are discussing about basic text of HTML 4.0. So our objective of today's sessions are History of HTML, basic HTML tags like HTML, head, title, body, HR, horizontal rule, image tag, embedded tag, background sound, blink tag, font tag, center tag, marquee tag, anchor tag, etc. So first we will see about the history of HTML. So HTML is stand for Hypertext Markup Language, and this language is used to create our web pages. In this full form as Hypertext Markup Language, hypertext is referred to the hyperlink. It is associated with the hyperlink. In hyperlink, we are using one text to refer that particular link is known as a hypertext. And markup language is a language which is made with the use of different text. So it is referred to the way of text are used to define the page layout elements within the page. That means ke all the text which are used to develop or designing the web page. HTML pages are created using the text editor like Notepad. You can use Notepad++ also. And this web page is saved as using extension .htm and .html. It is developed in 1989 and it is derived from the HTML, which is stand for Standard Generalized Markup Language. Now hypertext. So as we discussed earlier, a text which refers to the link is known as a hypertext. So hypertext is a text that link to the other information. By clicking on a link, if suppose we are clicking on a link, so we are directly not clicking a link, we are clicking on hypertext, and that hypertext is associated with the link. So user can quickly jump to the different page. It is always associated with the web pages. Now hyperlink, so it is in terms of text or image that you can click to jump to the new document. And whenever your cursor move on particular hyperlink, at that time arrow should be changed to the small hand pointing at the link. And whenever you are clicking on that particular link, a new page or new place in the current page will be open. For example, here I'm taking one link. I'm creating a link using an anchor tag. And here I'm passing a reference href. And my link is a VPMP website. Here I'm using a text which is referred to this link. So this text is known as a hypertext. And my hypertext is VPMP. I'm showing you okay, whenever I'm clicking on particular, holding my arrow on particular link, at that time my pointer will be displayed as a hand image. Okay. So here my hyperlink is VPMP website and hypertext is VPMP. HTTP is one type of protocol and it is stand for Hypertext Transfer Protocol. And it is used to transfer a data over the web. And basically it is a work on a servant client model. How it will work? So whenever you want to access a website, that means if you are searching for a Google page and you are passing your address as a www.google.com, at that time what happened, your browser will send that particular request to the web server. And web server will find out your particular request and respond it with an HTML status code. If your URL and your giving address is valid, then connection is granted. Otherwise, server will send you error message. Now we will turn into HTML tags. Our first basic tag is HTML tag. It is used to give instruction to the browser that you are opening a document in a HTML form. For example, is starting with HTML tag and ending with slash HTML tag. It is not a mandatory tag. It is optional tag. If suppose you are not writing HTML tag, then by default it will consider. Head tag is used for creating a heading. And it is work as a container for the sub tags like title, link, style and script. For example, to specify the title of document, we are using head tag. To specify the style sheet, we are using head tag. To specify the script in terms of Java or in terms of VB in HTML page, we are using a head tag. Like this, start with the HTML tag in which we are passing our heading. This is a heading within a head tag. So, starting point of head tag, your heading and closing of head tag, and finally we are closing our HTML tag. Next tag is a title tag. Title tag is a subtag of head tag which is used to give title of your web page. It is specify the title for web page. For example, we start with the HTML tag. It is a subtag of head tag, so we have to start with the head tag in which we have to specify the title, like this is a document title, ended with the slash and title tag, closing our head tag and closing our HTML tag. So we will get output like this. This is document title. Here my title is showing and this is a heading. This is my heading is showing. Body tag. So body tag is used to define a document's body. So remaining our all the tags we have to write within a body tag. It is work as a container for a text, hyperlinks, images, font, HTML list, etc. For example, I'm starting my document with the HTML tag. Here I'm specifying heading in which I'm using a title tag. I'm giving my title my first HTML tag. Then after we will specify our body tag. And in body tag, I'm writing one text message, welcome to my website. Now HTML tag is closing. Horizontal route tag. It is used to display a horizontal line in a web page. It is very similar to the underline tag. Attributes of HR tag. So our first attribute is size attribute. So size attribute is used to give height of particular line. And it is used like this. Ki start with the HR tag. Specify size attribute is equal to give value of your size and close this tag. Second is width tag. It is used to give width of horizontal line. Like this. Ki HR tag start. Give value of width. Align. It is used to specify alignment of your line. Like in center you want to display the line. Left side or right side. Image tag. It is used to display image on particular web page. And for displaying image tag, compulsory we have to use SRC attribute to specify the source of image. For example, IMG is my tag. Here I'm passing SRC tag and here specify source of image. Logo.jpg is my source of image. Here I'm using one more attribute, alt is equal to I'm specifying some text. Alt is used to alternative text for image. So, if suppose I'm giving some alternative text to the image, so at that time, whenever my image will be displayed on document and my cursor is moved on particular image, at that time this text will be displayed. Here I am passing width of image, height of image and border of image. Embed tag. It is used to embed multimedia files in terms of audio, video or flash file in a web page. And compulsory we have to use source attribute to pass the source of file. For example, embed tag, here we have to pass the source of file. One more attribute I am using, auto start and hidden attributes. BG sound tag is used to import background sound to the web page. It is used to embed a background sound file in the web page. This tag compulsory have to use SRC attribute. We compulsory have to pass SRC attribute. For example, BG sound SRC, here I am passing a source of background file and loop. One more attribute I am using, loop is equal to 2. That means ke 2 times my file will be run in the background. Blink tag. Blink tag is used to blink that particular text on and off on the web page. For example, for blink tag, I am using a blink tag. I am passing my text value, VPMP Polytechnic, complete the blink tag. So VPMP Polytechnic will blinking on the screen. Font tag, it is used for formatting the text, and this text with the use of this tag we can specify the font color, different size of font and different font face, that means ke font styles. For example, here I am passing the size is equal to 4, font style, it is known as a font face, Arial color, and here hello is my text. And complete the font tag. And my output will be like this. Hello will display in the red color. And font face is equal to Arial. And size is equal to 4. Center tag. So center tag is used for the alignment. For giving a text alignment in center, we are using this tag. Like this. Center tag. Here we have to specify our statement or any text message, complete the center tag. Marquee tag. So marquee tag is used to display the scrolling text on the web page from left to right, like to wrap, up to down, down to up, etc. So it is scrolled either in horizontally or vertically using this tag. And by default, our scrolling is horizontally left to right. For example, marquee tag, this is my text, complete the marquee tag. Here I am not using any attributes, so it will consider as a default attribute, horizontally left to right. Next example, here I am using a specific attribute direction left. That means ke my text will be scroll from left. Here I am passing a scroll delay. If suppose it is scroll left to right one time and then after it will delay for 1000 milliseconds and once again it will rotate from left to right. This is my text VPMP Polytechnic and marquee tag is completed. Anchor tag. As we had discussed earlier, it is used to define a link in a web page. It is used to create a hyperlink in a web page. And hyperlink is used to jump from one page to another page. For example, H is used for anchor tag. So start with the anchor tag, href, in which we have to pass the reference of a document. VPMP Polytechnic is my hyper text. So whenever I am clicking on VPMP Polytechnic, my document will be jumped to the vpmp.html document. Now working with the image, for that we are using image tag, img. So img tag is used to embed image on HTML document and some attributes of image tag. So first compulsory attribute is src. in which we have to specify the path of image. Width attribute, it is used to passing a width of image in terms of a pixel. Height attribute, it is also passed in terms of pixel size. Alt attribute, it is used to give the alternative text that you can be display in a place of a image. Now example of image tag. First we will start our document with passing a head, heading. Here we are passing a title of page. Body tag, in which one single statement we are passing HTML web page content, and then we are importing our image. Here I am using attribute source SRC. So this is my source file. Here I am passing a width of image in terms of pixel, height of image and alternative text. Complete your body tag and complete your HTML tag. So we will get the output like this. This is my body tag statement HTML web page content, and here our image penguin.jpg. Now image is used as a hyperlink. So it is possible to use image as a hyperlink. For that we have to use img tag with the anchor tag like this. Anchor tag, here we are passing a reference of hyperlink in terms of HTML page. Here we will use our image. Here I am passing a source of image. We will specify height, width, border, alignment, etc. attributes over here. Complete your anchor tag and you will get the output like book.jpg image will be displayed. Whenever you are clicking on that particular image, this page will be open. Thank you so much.